Mysterious locations, forbidden signs, a base set in the middle of nowhere censored on Google Earth, and tons of signs that point to the possibility of extraterrestrial life. Area 51 has been the subject of discussion for years, and many have attempted to find out the secrets that lie behind its closed doors. Join us as we have a look at some of the biggest secrets that are held in Area 51. The name behind Area 51. Area 51 derives its name from its marking on a 1950s Nevada test site map. That's really about all there is to it, which is nothing special. However, these four letters and two digits have managed to shake up even those who don't easily give in to conspiracy theory. Other names that Area 51 goes by are Groom Lake, which is the dry lake area that it was built around, the Paradise Ranch, Watertown, which is the official name of the test site, and Dreamland, after an Edgar Allan Poe poem. The traveler traveling through it may not dare not openly view it. Never its mysteries are exposed to the weak human eye unclosed. Sounds like a perfect description of Area 51, doesn't it? The consequences of crossing Area 51's borders. Area 51 is located in a restricted location, 83 miles northwest of Las Vegas. But before heading closer to the area, many like to stay in the extraterrestrial life-themed hotel, The Little Alien. Those who visit Area 51 and try to pass through the Do Not Cross sign on the road that lead to the base can tell you about the encounters they've had with security guards known as Camo Dudes. The area is actually heavily guarded and controlled by the government, but due to several ex-employee testimonials and strange sights close to the base, many suspect that the military is hiding much bigger secrets than it's actually willing to admit. By crossing over its borders, you can be punished in a various amount of ways, but one of the most common fines is a fee of about $600, depending on your intentions. Of course, it doesn't really stop anyone from snooping around and recording whatever they can to get a glimpse at what might be happening behind its walls. And it definitely didn't help that the state of Nevada decided to have some fun with the secrets and named the highway leading to Area 51 the Extraterrestrial Highway. So far, discoveries have included motion detectors, which alert security about trespassers, and many people that dare to step foot over the line indicating the border will also get a special visit from the FBI, while some get arrested. Area 51 was the A-12 Oxcart testing site. One of the things that we do actually know about Area 51 is that it was chosen as the testing site for the A-12 Oxcart. In simplified English, the A-12 Oxcart is the world's first titanium spy plane that flew about 2,200 miles per hour. That meant that the plane could cross over the continental United States in just 70 minutes. The plane's engines also act as a vacuum cleaner and sucks up any debris that's left on the runway. They also use the plane's cameras as a spy gadget when the USS Pueblo got captured by North Korea, and it's how they actually discovered the ship's location. Overall, the A-12 Oxcart is one of the reasons why Area 51 had to create an 8,500-foot runway and block land access and airspace from interfering with the testing site. Area 51 has an artillery and bombing site. One of the now well-known secrets of Area 51 is the artillery and bombing site known as Groom Lake, the dry lake that the area was built around. After World War II, the area became abandoned for a decade and then used as a testing facility for spy planes. Among others, the site was also used for the F-117 program, which tested the F-117 planes managed by first class and frontline pilots. The F-117 program was actually Area 51's home base until it was moved on to several other locations. Many actually believe that the moon landing occurred on Area 51. There are tons of conspiracy theories that surround our landing on the moon, with many skeptics out there and many, many YouTube videos and websites to go along. And it does leave you to think about it. If you have this large area that's in the middle of a desert, and there's absolutely nothing around it, There's really no way that anyone could ever know that you were going to film one of the world's most anticipated events ever. Pictures of Area 51 were taken in 1974. Now, let's just put it out there. Taking pictures of Area 51 is not exactly a legal thing to do. Of course, nowadays, a chunk of it can be found on satellite programs like Google Earth. However, just a decade or so ago, it was completely impossible. So when a Skylab astronaut decided to take pictures of the base, it became a big deal for everyone else back on Earth. Officials weren't happy, and Skylab actually got a memo from the CIA saying something to the effect that there were specific instructions not to do it. It was never discovered whether the whole thing was just an innocent mistake, or if the astronauts actually discovered something far more interesting and just couldn't hold it a secret anymore. The existence of aliens. Now, it's no secret that probably everyone who's ever heard of Area 51 will associate it with extraterrestrial life. From the extraterrestrial highway to the alien-themed hotel, along with testimonials by many ex-employees, it was back in the year of 2000 when a Russian satellite confirmed that Area 51 had a new complex of buildings, and one of these buildings included a gigantic hangar, along with a close to 12,000-foot long and 140-foot wide runway, which replaced the old one that was used for testing sites. Many also believe that the remains of a 1947 UFO crash in Roswell were carried over to Area 51, where they were analyzed and then further tested. In the 1980s, a former Area 51 employee came forward and testified that Area 51 had actually developed an antimatter-powered flying saucer on the base. However, these are not the only things that prove extraterrestrial life in the area. And of course, everyone remembers when they leaked a video of what seemed like an actual interview with an alien. But was it? The interview was confirmed by a man who called himself Victor, but wanted to keep his identity as hidden as possible. He stated that he didn't want to reveal too much in case they would have recognized him and he would get in trouble. But later, it would also be confirmed that the interview was in fact a hoax. In 2011, the government would release a statement that said that the government had no evidence that any life exists outside of our planet, or that an extraterrestrial presence had contacted or engaged any member of the human race. But how much truth is there to this statement? Does the president really get an insight into Area 51's activities, or is the base off-limits for even him? Ex-Area 51 employees and their testimonials. Now, it's debatable whether the activities of Area 51 are really off-limits. Over the years, many former employees have come forward and shared their stories on what actually goes on there, like Dr. Boyd Bushman, an ex-Area 51 scientist who claims that aliens are in fact real, that they're friendly, and that there's a group that works with aliens 24 hours a day. He also claims that two groups of aliens are currently being studied there, and that they're separated by their friendliness. In 2013, another video of a dying CIA agent was posted on YouTube. In it, the man made several claims about Area 51, including that the president was well aware of what was happening there. In a somewhat contradictory statement, a NASA employee also came forward stating that aliens did in fact exist, but that none were at Area 51. He also claimed that he had visited Area 51, but in his words, it was just a development and research space with no alien involvement whatsoever. While all Area 51 employees are sworn to secrecy, you just have to ask yourself, is there any truth to their statements? Or is it just another way to keep the public interested when in reality, the real secrets are somewhere else? The White House's response. In 2011, the White House was forced to release a response to two petitions that were signed by the public that demanded the acknowledgement of aliens having visited Earth, and also urged the White House to disclose any withholding of government interactions with extraterrestrial beings. They responded with, quote, "The U.S. government has no evidence that any life exists outside our planet. or that an extraterrestrial presence has contacted or engaged any member of the human race." End quote. They also claim that the odds of an extraterrestrial life form are actually high, but due to the distance it might take, it's highly unlikely that humans have actually made contact with aliens, yet alone be able to keep them hostage at Area 51. Barack Obama was also the first president to publicly acknowledge Area 51 in 2013, although he did so in a joking manner, and as a response to Shirley MacLaine's Lifetime Achievement Award. MacLaine is known as a believer in extraterrestrial life, and Obama acknowledged her passion by saying that being asked about Area 51 was one of the most common questions that he got, and that he'd always call MacLaine about what was going on. As part of her election campaign, Hillary Clinton was on record as saying that she would reveal as many Area 51 files as possible, and she also claimed that unless the information was a threat to national security, the public deserved to know about the area. And there is a kind of official Area 51 website, which is maintained by the Las Vegas Tourism Bureau. On the site, they state that the area has been used for the creation of exotic energy weapons, weather control experimentation, and most interesting, time travel and teleportation technology. On another thought, we'd really love to know more about time travel. The information that exists about Area 51 is so different from one story to the next that it actually makes you wonder, what on earth is Area 51 hiding? And when will we ever get a clear answer on whether humans have come into contact with aliens in the past few decades? What do you think about Area 51? What really goes on there? And is there any truth to ex-employee statements? Let me know all about it in the comments below, and thanks for watching. One of the strangest fetishes our possible interstellar neighbors have is the mutilation of cattle. Alien hysteria was at its peak at the beginning of the 1940s and ending in the late 1990s. During this time, millions of unsubstantiated reports of alien activities flooded local news and police stations around the country,